Hello and welcome to the channel. Some outgoing state governors are already carrying on I don't care attitude as they get set to go next week, especially those whose re-election bid failed. They are ghosting their successors, not running a smooth transition on generally just being difficult to work with. We will drag some of them here today, but first, subscribe, like, share, and comment. Thank you. Governors-elect protest as outgoing governors shun transition panels. There are strong indications that the transition process is not going smoothly in many states as the outgoing governors are allegedly not cooperating with their successors. Following the development, the panel set up by the incoming governors are asking questions on the financial conditions of the states, thus generating tension. In Zamfara State, Governor Bello Matawalle was accused of not cooperating with the incoming administration of Dauda Dare ahead of the inauguration on May 29. The publicity secretary of the People's Democratic Party in the state, Faruku Ahmed, in an interview with The Punch on Monday, stressed that since Matawalle lost his re-election bid, he had abandoned the state and had been avoiding the governor-elect. Ahmed further alleged that Matawalle left the state 2 months ago and was not cooperating with the incoming administration in terms of the transition program. Ahmed said, "The incoming administration of Dauda Lawan Dare has been trying to get some relevant information from the outgoing administration, but Governor Bello Matawalle is not willing to cooperate with the committees appointed by the incoming governor to find out the true picture of things." Based on this, the incoming governor appointed subcommittees to go around the ministries, departments, and other agencies in order to get relevant information because Governor Matawalle is not willing to prepare handing over notes. He condemned those condemning the committee appointed by the governor-elect to investigate ministries, departments, and other government agencies in the state. He said Dare had every right to appoint committees to furnish him with relevant information on the activities of the outgoing administration so that he would know where to start and how to recover some government properties and funds allegedly diverted by the outgoing administration of Governor Bello Matawalle in the last 4 years. The incoming governor recently constituted a committee under the leadership of a former Inspector General of Police, Mohammed Abubakar, to ensure the smooth handing on taking over of government on May 29. Since Governor Matawalle is not ready to cooperate with the incoming administration, the appointed committees will find out the true situation of things for the incoming administration. So we will not wait until the handing over date. We will continue to invite top civil servants and public office holders to come and make clarifications, the PDP spokesman declared. But the publicity secretary of the Zamfara State All Progressives Congress, Yusuf Idris, faltered the allegation that Matawalle had abandoned the state, describing the claim as untrue. Speaking to the Punch on the phone, Idris explained that the governor had only traveled outside the state for important functions. He said it was not possible for Ahmed to know whether the governor was in the state or not. He noted, "Governor Matawalle has been coming to the state but goes back to attend some important functions for the progress of the state. Whoever told you that he has been away since the time he lost the election is only saying so to tarnish his image. I want people to understand that whether the governor is in the state or not, the government's activities are going on smoothly without any hindrance." The State Commissioner for Information, LRG Ibrahim Dosara, also criticized Dare for appointing committees to get information on the activities of ministries, departments, and agencies. Dosara, in a statement, said this was illegal as Matawalle was still the governor until May 29. He therefore asked the MDAs and other agencies to desist from releasing any information to the incoming administration without the consent of the transition committee appointed by the outgoing administration. a statement read in part. This is to inform the general public that it has come to the attention of Zamfara State Government that some members of the incoming government transition committee are currently going around ministries and departments of the government, collecting information and conducting investigations into the activities of the MDAs. In Benue, there seems to be no love lost between the governor-elect, Reverend Father Hyacinth Alaya, and the outgoing administration following the controversy trailing the two transition committees set up by Governor Samuel Otom and Alaya. The APC publicity secretary in the state, Daniel Ihomon, who spoke on behalf of Mike Ihodai, the chairman of the transition committee, said he was not enjoying the cooperation of the state government committee headed by the secretary to the state government, Professor Tony Ijoho-san. He further lamented that the presidential lodge, the expected temporary lodge for the governor-elect, had not been renovated. He said, the outgoing administration has been recruiting more people at a time. It cannot pay those who are in the service for over 10 months. It cannot pay pensioners, yet it is recruiting more people to add to the burdens of the incoming government. This is a government that did not recruit for over 7 years. So the question is, why now? Subscribe, like, share, comment, and please turn the notification bell on. Thank you. But the state government has declared it will formally hand over power to the incoming administration on May 28. Addressing journalists after the State Executive Council meeting, the Commissioner for Information and Orientation, Mike Inalegwu, said this was to enable the incoming administration to celebrate and reduce the cumbersome transition processes on May 29. In Kano State, the outgoing government of Governor Umar Ganduje was also accused of not collaborating with the New Nigeria People's Party Transition Committee under the chairmanship of Dr. Bapa Bishi. The committee recently addressed a press conference where it alleged that Ganduje was undermining the transition program by not providing the necessary cooperation. Speaking to our correspondent, the chief press secretary to the governor-elect, Sanusi Tofa, stated, it was after that press conference we started getting cooperation, but not full cooperation or as expected. But a top government official of the state government who spoke on condition of anonymity told the Punch on the telephone on Monday that the Ganduje administration had provided the NNPP transition committee with all what it needed. The official who expressed satisfaction with the committee's performance so far called for understanding in order to ensure a hitch-free transition of power on 29 May 2023. The same situation has been experienced in Abia State, where the transition committee set up by the governor-elect, Alex Oti, is reportedly having issues with the outgoing governor, Okezie Igbiazu. That's the news, guys. Thanks for listening. Until next time, bye.